Hi guys, welcome to the session of time and work, a topic from quantitative ability. I'm your quantitative ability tutor, Kasturi San. Guys, today we are going to cover time and work, which is another examiner's favorite, and most of the people find it really difficult to deal with time and work questions. Why? Probably because they do not understand the concept which is related with time and work, and they watch a number of videos or read a number of books which talk only about shortcut without understanding the basic concept. So here in this video, I'm going to solve each and every question in a traditional approach. I'll help you understand the concept, and once you get the concept, nevertheless, you may not save 2-3 seconds of your precious time by going by the traditional way, but you will surely get the right answer. So here we are, let's begin today's session of time and work. And for each question, depending on the difficulty level, you will be getting 90 seconds or 60 seconds or 1 minute or 1.5 minute. Few of the problems in this session are really easy, so I don't think that the difficulty level overall is advanced. It is medium difficulty. These kind of questions do appear in many of the bank exams or the higher level exams like RBI grade B or SEBI NABARD, but then these kind of questions may not appear in CAT. A bit difficult level questions can appear in CAT. If you're preparing for CAT, then please use these videos just for understanding the concept. So let us get to the first question. The first question says there is sufficient food for 1600 men for 120 days and each one takes 900 gram of food every day. But after 80 days, 400 men leave the place and now each one can take 1000 gram of food every day. For how many days will the rest of the food last for the rest of the men? So here we are given the initial condition wherein there is 1600 men and the food lasts for 120 days and each man is taking 900 grams of food. And then we are given the new condition which says that now after 80 days, 400 men have left. So total we are left out with 1200 men and they are taking 1000 gram of food for X days. So we have to find out the value of X, which is the value of the number of days that the food is going to last. So guys, this is an easy question and your time starts now. You are given 1 minute time to solve this kind of a question. Your time starts now. Alright guys, the time has ended. 1 minute time was enough to solve this kind of a question. All it required was, guys, listen carefully what the question is asking us and what is already stated in the question. So there is sufficient food for 1600 men for 120 days and each one is taking 900 grams of food. So how much food do we have in total? We have 1600 into 120 into 900 grams of food. So this is the total available food. Now what they are saying is after 80 days 400 men leave. So till 80 days we had 1600 men who were taking 900 grams of food. So what do I have? I have 1600 men who were taking 900 grams of food and for how many days? For 80 days. Now they are saying that 400 men have left. So total I have 1200 men And total, they are taking 1000 gram of food instead of 900. They are now taking 1000, and I have to find out the number of days, which is, let us assume that it is x. So I have to find out the value of x. All I do is I simplify this equation, I simplify this, and I get the value of x. So the value of x comes out as 48 days. I am sure most of you have got this value of x. All you have to do is you have to calculate it very, very fast. So guys, this one was an easy one, and I wanted to start with an easy one because there are so many people who do not understand the concept of time and work. So I wanted to go step by step. And now we are again towards our second easy question, which is work done by x plus 4 men in x plus 5 days is equal to work done by x minus 5 men in x plus 20 days. What is the value of work? What is the value of x? Sorry. So again, guys, this is a very, very simple question, and your time starts now. Again, you have 1 minute time left, guys. This is an easy one. Okay guys, your 1 minute time has ended, and let us see how to solve this kind of question. So we have work done, which is equal to the number of days, or I can say work done is directly proportional to the number of days into the number of people working into the number of hours. If we have number of hours, if we are given it in terms of hours, then we have this particular equation, we have this particular relation. So remember, work done is directly proportional to the number of days into number of people working into number of hours. So this is the same equation that we are going to use. What are we given? X plus 5 men are completing the work in X plus 5 days. So basically, we have work which is one, which is done by those people, and it is done by X plus 4 men in X plus 5 days. Correct? Now, I have this work which is equal to the work done by X minus 5 men in X plus 20 days. So all I do is I cancel this out. I get this equation, I solve it, and I get the value of x. So the x value comes out as 20. If you solve this is a quadratic equation. If you solve it, you get the value of x as 20. Okay, guys, now let us move to the next problem. The next one is also a similar kind of a problem. So again, you're going to get 1 minute to solve this problem. The ratio of the amount of work done by x minus 1 laborers in x plus 1 days and that done by x plus 1 laborers in x plus 2 days is 5 is to 6. Find the value of x. So again, another easy one which is very similar to the last problem. So please solve it now, and your time begins now. Okay guys, your 1 minute time has ended and let us find out the value of x. We use the same relation, which is work done is directly proportional to the number of days into number of people into number of hours that they put. So here we have the ratio x minus 1 laborers, they are working for x plus 1 days and they are completing 5 of the work. Divided by, we have x plus 1, I am taking the ratio, so I have x plus 1 into x plus 2, 5 by 6 is equal to 5 by 6, this particular ratio. And all I do is, I cross multiply, I simplify and find the value of x. The value of x comes out as 16, most of you have got this answer, all you have to do is calculate it really quick. So guys, now let us move to the fourth problem. Again, a very easy problem. I have started off with easy problems so that you get confidence. Yes, you can solve time and work problems. They are really simple. Let's understand the concept and then we can solve any problem. A group of men decided to do a job in 4 days, but 20 men dropped out every day. The job was completed at the end of 7th day. Find the initial number of men. So guys, I'm going to give you a hint of how to go ahead with these kind of problems. Assume that there are X men. Assume that initially they started off with X men. And then every day, 20 men are dropping. So every day you have X, on the second day you have X minus 20 men working. On the third day you have X minus 40 men working. On the fifth day you have, similarly, go ahead. You will subtract 20 men every time for every day. And finally, you will get the value x minus something at the end of the 7th day. So, you have to find out the initial number of men. You have to find out the value of x. So, guys, your time starts now. Okay guys, your 1 minute time has ended and here we are given one information that X men together can do the complete job in 4 days. So can I say that in 1 day, X men are doing 1/4 job, which is 25% of job in 1 day? Can I say in 1 day, one man is doing 1/4x job? Correct, because there are X men working together. So in one, when I calculate what is the job done by one man, I have to divide X here. So my 4X comes in the denominator. Now we are told that 20 men dropped out every day. So on the first day, we had X people working. So on the first day, we had X people working. So that day's job is going to be 1/4x into x, which is one man's job into the number of people working. When I find out the second day, how many people do we have? X minus 20, correct? So what do I have? I still have 4x here at my denominator, but here I am going to have x minus 20. I am going to multiply it by x minus 20. What happens on the third day? So on the third day, I have x minus 40 people. And my numerator changes to x minus 40 upon 4x. Now what happens on the fourth day? I have x minus 60 people working. So I get x minus 60 upon 4x. On the fifth day, I have x minus 80 people working. So again, I get x minus 80 upon 4x. On the sixth day, I have 100 people who leave the job, who leave. So I have x minus 100. Same thing, 4x divided by 4x. And on the seventh day, finally, when the job gets completed, I have 120 men leaving. So I get x minus 120 upon 4x. When I add all these together, that should equal to 1, because the job gets completed. You're doing 100% of the job. So you have to add everything together and find out the value of x. So the value of x comes out as 140. So the initial number of men is 140. I hope you've understood what I have done. I've calculated what is the job done by one man in one day, when I had x men who are doing the job in 4 days. And I have multiplied it by the number of men who are present on that particular day. Finally, I have added all the values and have equated it to 1, because the job is being done. And finally, I get the answer of my x, which is 140. So guys, let us go to the next problem. 3 men, A, B and C, complete the work in such a way that A works for all 5 days, B works for first, second day, and C works for 3rd, 4th and 5th day. If B plus C can do as much work in 2 days as A alone can do in 3 days, in how many days A, B, C alone can do the work if B plus C can complete the whole work without the help of A? This had to be without the help of A in 6 days. So guys, your time starts now and you will be given 1.5 minute time to solve this question. Okay guys, your time of 1.5 minute is over. Now let us see how we can solve this particular problem. Guys, whenever you're given problems which is related with 3 people, 2 people or whatever number of people, always find out, even in the previous problem we did the same thing, always find out what is the amount of work that is done in one day. So here guys, we have given that B and C can complete the work without the help of A in 6 days. So basically we are given that B and C can together work in 6 days. So what is the amount of work that B and C can do in one day. So in one day we have B plus C together, they can do 1/6 of the work, correct? Also, we are given B plus C does as much work in 2 days as A can alone do in 3 days. So basically, guys, here we are given efficiency. So the efficiency, can I say, of B plus 3 together is 3 and of A is 2. The ratio of efficiency is 3:2 for B plus C and A, because A is doing the same work in 3 days, which B plus C are together doing in 3 days. So B plus C are having more efficiency than A. But what is given that B plus C are doing the work, they are completing the work in 6 days. So in one day, they are doing 1/6 of the work. So when I multiply this by 2/3, when I multiply 1 by 6 by 2 by 3, I'll get the time that A takes in order to do the work alone, all by himself. So this goes off and I get 1 by 9. So 1 by 9th amount of work is done by A in one day. So A takes 9 days to complete the work. A takes 9 days to complete the work. I have got my first answer at least that A is taking 9 days. Do they have been given any other information? Yes, they have given another equation which says that A works for 5 days. So each day A is doing 1/9th work. So in 5 days, he is going to do 5 into 1/9th work. Plus, we are given B is working for 2 days. And we are given that C is working for 3 days. And they are completing the work. When they complete the work, the addition has to equal 1. So this is again another equation that we are given. So I am just going to rub out a few things here. So this is one of the equation and it comes out as 5/9 plus 2b plus 3c equal to 1. I have again another equation which is dealing with b and c, and this is and it is this equation, b plus c equal to 1/6. So when I multiply this by 2, all I get is 2b plus 2c equal to 1/3. I am just going to cancel out. I am just going to solve this simultaneously, subtract it basically. I get 5/9, bb gets cancelled, plus c equal to 2/3. So the value of my c comes out as 6 minus 5/9, which is 1/9. So which means that c is also taking 9 days to solve this particular, to complete this particular work. Now the value of my b, I put the value of c in this particular equation and I get the value of b as 1/6 minus 1/9. So that comes out as, the value of my b comes out as 3 minus 2/18, which comes out as 1/18. So b can alone do the work in 18 days. So I have A and C doing the work in 9 days, and I have B who is doing the work alone in 18 days. So this is the answer that I have got. This whole question was related with solving two simultaneous equations and getting two simultaneous equations and solving them for the value of A, B and C. So whenever you get these kind of a problem, always find out what is the work done by each person in one single day. In this particular problem, we were also given the ratio of the efficiencies. So always remember that the more efficient person is going to take less amount of days to do that particular work. And that is one very important hint that you get. So whenever you given the ratio and you don't know what to multiply and what to divide, remember that the efficient person is going to take less number of days. Efficiency is inversely proportional to the time taken. So remember this in layman's language, more the efficient person, less the time he is going to take. Now with this, let us go to the sixth problem. A swimming pool is fitted with three pipes. The first two pipes working simultaneously fill the pool in the same time as the third pipe alone. The second pipe alone fills the pool 5 hours faster than the first pipe and 4 hours slower than the third pipe. In what time second and the third pipe together fills the pool? So guys, this is again an easy one. I think I'm going to give you 1 minute to solve this particular question. So guys, your time starts now. Okay guys, your 1 minute time has ended. So what we are given here is that there are three pipes and the first two pipes are working simultaneously to fill the pool the same time in the same time as the third pipe alone. Okay, we'll get back to the statement, but let's read the second statement. The second pipe alone fills the pool 5 hours faster than the first pipe. What if I have three pipes A, B and C, and let us assume that the third pipe is taking x hours to fill it. So we have the second pipe which fills the pool 5 hours faster than the first pipe, 4 hours slower than the third pipe. So which means that the B pipe is going to take 4 hours more, that is x plus 4 hours, in order to fill that particular swimming pool. But also another information that is given is that it is 5 hours faster than the first pipe. So the first pipe is going to take x plus 9 hours to fill the particular pool. So guys, this is all we needed actually. And now find out in 1 hour how much amount of the pool is being filled by A, B and C, all these three pipes. So all we do is we take the reciprocal. So in 1 hour, A is going to fill 1 upon x plus 9, B is going to fill 1 upon x plus 4 and C is going to fill 1x. Now we go to the first equation. Two pipes working simultaneously fill the pool in the same time as the third pipe. So which means 1 upon x plus 9 work done by A and B together is same as work done by C. So that is all that we need and we can solve this for x. So let us see what we get when we solve it for x. So we have x plus 4 plus x plus 9 upon x square plus 13x plus 36 equal to 1 upon x. Take this x. So I have this 13x getting cancelled. I have x square equal to 36. So x comes out as 6. I'm going to ignore the negative value. X can be minus 6 also. But what is my x? My x is a number of hours. So it cannot be minus 6. So what we have to find out, guys, the options given, they had 6 in it also. But we are not asked what is the value of x. We are asked what time second and third pipe will take to fill together. So my B is taking 6 plus 4, that is 10, and my C is taking 6 hours to fill it. So if both of them are simultaneously working, then I have 1 upon 10 plus 1 upon 6 and the time taken is 16 upon 60. So the time taken is the reciprocal of this, which is 60 upon 16. So that comes out as 15 upon 4. Which is nothing but 3.75 hours. So the correct answer here is 3.75 hours. Now let us go to the next question. A takes as much time as B plus C to finish the job. A plus B finish the job in 10 days, while C alone can do the job in 15 days. How many days B alone can take to complete the whole job? So guys, here we are given in one day C is doing 1/5 of the job. In one day A plus B are taking doing 1/10 of the job, and A is taking as much time as B plus C. So A is equal to B plus C. So find out what is the value of B, and your 1 minute time starts now. Okay guys, your time has ended, and this was a really simple one. All I do is I substitute the value of A here in this particular equation, and I get A is nothing but B plus C. So I have B plus C plus B is equal to 1 upon 10. So I have 2B equal to 1 upon 10 minus C. My C is what? 15. So all I do is take the LCM, I get the answer. Now this is 2B, so B is going to complete the work in 60 days. So the correct answer here is 60 days. Alright guys, so I've solved this problem in really less than a minute, less than 30 seconds in fact. This one was a really easy one. I hope you guys don't have a fear for time and work problems now. We will be solving more advanced level problems which involves 2 men, 3 women, 5 children. Working together and doing a job which are related with wages and efficiencies in the next session. This was just an introductory session I wanted to take, because most of the times I get messages saying that time and work is really difficult. So I thought that this session is important so that I can make that fear go from your mind. I hope you all have solved a lot of questions correct from this set of questions. And with this particular problem, I am ending the video. See you again with the next session related with time and work. Thank you so much, guys.